My name is Anne-Dominique Salamin. I'm a professor at my university. I come from Switzerland, French part. I'm sure you can notice by my accent. I'll try my best to be understandable. I have the honor and the burden to present a 2 years project in 7 minutes. In our university, we are the second largest university in Switzerland, and we have 22,000 students, 6 faculties, and so on. If you want to contact us, you have some information here. I'm talking about MOOCs. We wanted to realize MOOCs, but as you can see on the slide, we are too small, too poor to publish on a platform, regular platform like Coursera or edX. But still, we think that MOOCs could be interesting for our university. And we didn't want to realize a platform, another one, because as you know, there are so many platforms in the world, and the world doesn't deserve a new one. Besides, we didn't want to mix our regular students and the future participants to the MOOCs in one platform. This is a decision of our rectorate. We are user of Moodle since quite the beginning, 2004, and every day almost the complete panel of our students and professors are using Moodle every day. Above all, many presenters during this conference talked about the issues about privacy in Europe, the GDPR, for example, and we want to host data in Switzerland. Nothing against, you know, US or any other countries, but we want to host data in home. So we decided to manage a platform, a proper and our own MOOC platform. And we decided to build on our large experience of Moodle. So we forked, this is a computing term, basically we duplicated Moodle, we simplified the interface, we automated some processes like, for example, certification delivery or peer grading or even forum and things like this. We developed an adaptive quiz activity, which, by the way, we are intending to develop as a plugin. It means adaptive activity means adapted to every student individually. It's on the way of personalization. And we called it MoodEC X. Who can use this platform? Anybody who has a manager role, because it's not for a professor, I would say a regular user. It's much more for manager, Moodle managers. You just have to download it. I'm gonna show you where, and to deploy it on your server and try it. Some question, if you develop MOOCs, could you ask us to host your MOOCs? The answer is no. You have to deploy your own platform and to build on this platform. That's why it's called MoodEC X. Is it free? Of course, as we use Moodle as a base, we have exactly the same philosophy of openness. Maybe you were here in the beginning of this day to listen to people who are talking about openness. It's exactly the same philosophy we have here. The problem could be the maintenance. Are we going to maintain this platform if by chance you want to use it? Yes, we are going to maintain it as Moodle offer a release every year. We should try to make MoodEC X usable and on the proper way as Moodle does. Can you use this platform? Because sometimes people say that Moodle is nice, but you know, it's a very, very huge plane, and sometimes you just have just need something lighter. Yes, you could use this lighter solution, but I think it would be not very interesting because we really deactivated all the functionalities that are not useful for MOOCs, but maybe could be useful for other courses. So better stick to Moodle for regular courses. What does it like? Just some screenshots. This is the landing page, the home page of the system for MOOCs, and you can see some MOOCs, some pictures of the MOOCs coming or MOOCs now running. And here is the page where you can enroll to the course. And here are two pictures of the content of the course. This is a course about oral communication. And you see that we decided to be very flat and very simple. We just put some labels to organize resources and data. And you can see, I cannot turn my head unless you don't listen to me. And we just put some icons to know what kind of resources are provided. If you want to sign up for some MOOCs, you can. It's not exactly the platform, but if you want to try, you can, because we have some MOOCs in English. And of course, for us, what would be interesting is that some of you, all of you, part of you, I don't know, would download the MOODEC and play with it and try maybe to crash it, which is impossible because it's based on Moodle and it's very, very stable, but could try to give us a feedback and give us information about what we should change in the system or not. If you want more information about the project, you have a link here to understand what we are doing with this MOOC. If you need some help, you can join us at this address. And in the end, if you want to talk to the real guy who worked on the project, it's Cyril, and you can, of course, join him and have more information about this platform. Thank you very much for your attention, and if you have some questions, I'll be glad to answer. Any question? I can barely see you because of the lights. No? Okay, thank you very much.